Hello YouTube, Red Demon on here with another video. Today we're going to be playing Accident something. I can't remember the exact name. It's Accident something or other. It's to do, oh, Accident the Pilot. Okay, so Accident the Pilot, that's what we're going to be playing today. It seems pretty interesting. So yeah, we're going to give that a try and see what happens. It's been a minute since I did a YouTube video. I've been just uploading Steam videos, or not Steam videos, stream recordings. Due to the fact I just didn't have the time to do both. I'm trying to make some time for that. The overlay I'm using here is actually an overlay I built for somebody else, but I haven't been able to give it to them yet. So I thought I'd give it a try and see what people actually think of this overlay. It's hand built by me. I've been tweaking it and twisting it. I saw it happen, little things all over the view. You know, having a game in the background behind twigs and leaves and roses and things like that would be a pretty cool way to go about things. So it looks like we're heading to this accident. So we'll give this game a go. Looks pretty though. So first step first is to quickly get out of the car. Let's go. I gotta shut my car off first. Okay, now what? What are you trying to get me to do here? Okay, well, you wouldn't call emergency services first. You would actually want to shut your car off and immediately get out and shut that car off. Immediately, you want to turn the car off, not do this. Like doing the phone call thing, that's time wasted that these people can be injured or hurt. Which to me makes no sense to do this first. But, it is what it is. I'm actually going to shut the truck off and shut the cars off before I put the next one down. I understand. Let me get in this car, shut the ignition off. Because we need to, where is it? Okay, shut that off. Alright. Let me back out. I don't know why I had to climb in the guy's truck to do that. And that person in the car in the back there is probably not alive. So, with her not being alive, wouldn't make sense for me to climb in and get her out of that. But, I am going to go put the fire out first. Because that is important. Even if the body, even if the person's on fire. Fire extinguisher. It is not going out. It's only on this side. Come on now, put it out. Oh, screw that. Why can't I grab the kid out? Okay. First aid kit, we're gonna grab that. Nobody else has a fire extinguisher. These guys are gonna die. I swear they're gonna die because trunk's locked. Door's locked. There a release lever for the trunk in here? No. Dang. The one car that is left is the one car that I can't get into. And none of the cars have markers. Yeah, this is definitely not a good sign. Oh, I tried putting that car out. Ghost lanes don't go nowhere. And that ain't my problem, because look, I literally just put the fire out. There's a fire extinguisher in this cab somewhere. You mean to tell me you don't carry a fire extinguisher in this cab? Yep, they're dead. They're dead. This is a fail. I might as well just stand back and watch these people die because, yeah. And I don't know why that's locked. There, we're just gonna watch them die because ain't nothing I can do. I've done everything by the book. But, of course, there's not much I can do. Because it won't let me interact with the people. Because it makes you do shit out of order. I'm sorry, I worked on the scene before. There ain't no way in hell you're not gonna sit there and tell me that when you pull up to an accident, you're gonna pull up your phone and call 911. No, you're gonna tell somebody they call 911 while you immediately go and rescue the person in the burning car because the other two cars are not that bad. But of course, I have to do it in a specific order. So now I have to go and shut off all ignition. Let's see. Follow step by step. Turn on hazards. Bam. Grab a smartphone. Bam. Get the hell out of this car. One. Call 911. Or 112. Wherever country I'm in. Let me out of this damn plane. Time is a waste in here. Let me out. Alright, immediately pop trunk. Alright, shut off ignitions to vehicles. Immediately. Because this one's going to take a while. I'm going to immediately shut this one off because I have to climb in the car. Shut it off. Climb back out. See, you wouldn't climb into someone's vehicle. You would literally just reach over and shut it off. Same with the truck. You wouldn't climb in to shut the truck off. You would just reach up and you would climb up, grab the key, turn it off. You wouldn't sit in the seat. Shut the ignition off of that. Grab the marker for back here, since I gotta run the other way anyhow. Grab the marker for back here. Put the marker down. See, this is the thing I'm talking about, is some of this stuff don't make no sense. For what it is. Because one, that car is burning constantly. There's a person right in front, right behind the flames. That's gonna burn to death because I have to run all the way back to my car after shutting off all the ignitions to put down the placard, the marker. So yeah. And then I have to run all the way down here to put this marker. And as you see, their lives are going, excuse me. I don't know what's happening. Their lives are going all the way down the way they're going. And that's not a good sign. Because in the time period of an accident this bad, most of those people are going to be dead. Right now, the only one that will probably survive, if any, would be the guy in the red car. If he's lucky. and out of extinguisher, grab the next one. You see what I mean, though? Something's not right. If I'm sitting here doing this, and it's not going out, something's not right. Put out the fire that you can't, because the fire extinguisher doesn't put out the fire. It says the door is locked, yet you can hop up in here, but you can't hit the switch to unlock the door over there. I don't know. I am so confused why the fire is not going out. Like, look, the fire went down to dick all. Just to put out the fire. Yeah, the fire is doing dick all. And I can't grab this person now. There. I don't know. This game's making no sense. Put out the fire, yeah. I go and put out the, you know what? I'm gonna restart again, and I'm gonna immediately just put out the fire. Come on, get me to the thing. Get me to the thing. This might be a failed video of me not being able to do this because the game itself is broken. Alright, so. I'm immediately going to try to put out this fire. If it can't be put out, that's going to annoy me. Because I see the fire. Alright, so, it took a whole damn can to put out the fire. Okay, let me just put up the marker over here since I'm already over here. So that I don't have to come back for it. Marker up. Then on my way back through, I'll just shut off the ignition. And then grab the other marker. But yeah. That is definitely what I was saying. Is like, for some reason, it wasn't working. And then it would. And then it wouldn't again. So I was kind of confused on the aspect of that. Alright. Come on, open the door. Get in. Immediately shut the ignition off, get out. I don't know why I'm shutting the ignition off to this rig. It's not like the rig is that affected. And I have to actually go in on this side. For some dumb reason, the person won't reach over the driver to turn it off. But now I gotta do that. Quickly go and grab my placard. It's right here. And hope that I have enough time to just literally save two of the people. Because as you see in the bottom left there, one dead. Two are questionable that they might survive, and one should survive. So, yeah. We do got another med kit there if needed. Alright, so we need to first examine. He's probably dead. But. Alright. He's alive. So we got one somewhat alive. We got one dead already, or questionably dead. Okay, he's dead. Oh no, he's alive. He's just unconscious. That's surprising that he's actually alive. This lady's dead one. I guarantee she's the dead one. She's dead. And then this little one. Oh. All right, now what I need to do is check your exact location. One. I don't know why we're running out of time. We're gonna lose two of them because of it. The first one I'm getting to is the kid, because that's the one we're gonna lose first. And I'd rather not lose a kid on the first time around. Come on now. Gloves. They really want you to have a lot of throw on your mouth. Good lord, you need like a fucking massive desk to do what they ask you to do. Yep, breathing. A scenario failed. Oh, you know I'm not doing that. No. Where did I fail at? That dude was still alive. They were all still alive. You know. Now, we're going to leave it there, guys. Something's fishy about this game. So, yeah. Because, as you notice, when I gave him CPR, there was still a bar there. So, somehow time sped up. So, yeah. We'll play this again at some point. It's just probably because it's late right now when I'm recording this. But we will give this another try at some point. But you all have a wonderful night. Day, afternoon, whatever it is for you. We will play this again, and hopefully the next time we play it, it ain't gonna be me with frustration. And sorry about the messy hair. I just didn't feel like doing my hair up today. But yeah, we'll catch y'all in the next one, and see you then, boys and girls and